Children, Sai Ram, and welcome back to the second session of our lesson number 4, the freedom struggle of 1857. Children, in the previous lecture we have learned about the discontent among the people. Okay, the people, there was a discontent, okay, which led to the struggle of 1857. Then there was discontent among the farmers. Okay, you all must be knowing, we have learned in the previous lesson about the discontent among the farmers and the revolt that they took place because of this. Okay, then we have learned about the famine that had taken place in Bengal. Then the people's revolt, because of which Umaji Naik, who had organized the Ramoshis and the local youths and gave a tough fight to the Britishers, because of which others were also inspired, like from Pune, Satara, Ahmednagar. Okay, these were the places. From here also people got inspired by this. Then because of which, what happened? Umaji Naik was arrested and hanged till death. Then this is a picture of Umaji Naik we have already seen in the previous part. Then we have also learned about the tribal revolt. The tribal people also started revolting against the British. Because what was the reason behind that? The British had started imposing taxes and putting restrictions on the daily work what they were doing, on the forest work. Okay, so which were the tribal people who went against the British? That is Kolam area of Chota Nagpur, Gonds of Orissa, Santals of Bihar, okay, and the Mundas of Jharkhand. Okay, one of the youth called as Birsa Munda from Jharkhand, he also objected to this and started a revolt. You can see in this picture, Birsa Munda is instructing the tribal people. Then not only this tribal people, even the Gadkaris from Kolhapur, the Phone Savan from the Konkan, all this also people challenged the British. Then even the Zamindars and royal class, they also were in this category now. They were also against the British. They also did not support the British now. Okay, so all these were the people who went against the British. Okay, so this was the part which we have already learnt in the previous lecture. Let's continue, children. Next part we are going to learn is about the soldiers. Even the Indian soldiers. Now who are these Indian soldiers? The soldiers were working for the Britishers. Along with the British army, even the Indian soldiers were working with them. Okay, the Indian soldiers working for the East India Company, they were called as sepoys. Now, whoever were working for this Britishers, they were ill-treated. They were not given any respect. The condition was too bad, even being in that soldiers. Okay, then also they were very much ill-treated. They were not paid well. They were not getting salary on time. Okay, then they had to leave their houses and go for a war. Okay, leaving their family behind, they had to go for a war, which the soldiers did not like at all. You all must be knowing, the Indian people were very much attached to their families, and when they had to leave their family and go outside for fighting wars, they got very much discontented about this. Okay, in the year 1806 at Vellore and in 1824 at Barrackpore, a fierce revolt took place. I'll tell you about this revolt in the upcoming part of the lesson. Okay, now what is this revolt? Revolt here means again a fight from the side of the soldiers. As these revolts were single-handed, all this, that is the tribal people, the farmers, then Umaji Naik, all these revolts which were there, they were single-handed. They were not united at all. Okay, single-handed, one time farmers came, they were against, then they revolted, nothing happened. Then the soldiers revolted, nothing happened. So what happened here? It was easy, very much easy for the Britishers to break it. Whatever revolt was taking place, to break that revolt, it was very much easy for the Britishers because they were not united at all. If at all, the soldiers, the common people, then the others also would have come together. Then only this revolt have been of some use. But it was not so. People were not knowing each other properly. What they are going to come together and revolt. For time being, okay, when the Britishers stopped this or suppressed this, for time being the people became quiet. okay, they stopped all this revolt and all, and the discontent was suppressed for time being. But later, what happened? There was an overburst, okay, outburst. When it was an outburst? In the freedom struggle of 1857. Okay, we'll see in the upcoming part of the lesson how this outburst was. You can see this picture. This picture is of a sepoy, that is an Indian soldier. Now, what were the causes for the struggle of 1857? What were the main causes? Why the people wanted this struggle? Why the people needed this struggle? Prior to the British rule, okay, before the British rule, there were many kingdoms in India. Small kingdoms were there in India. Now, if any change was taking place in the central part of the kingdom, the villages were not at all affected by that. Okay, suppose if there is a kingdom. Okay, now I'll show you. If this is a kingdom. Okay, if in the center where the king is, if any changes are taking place over here, okay, the villages over here are not at all affected. Okay, they keep on running smoothly. Okay, whatever changes are there, that will take place over here only. Okay, and no changes will go about in the villages. The villages were self-sufficient, they were in their own world, they will do whatever they feel. Okay, their own justice, everything their own. And they were self-sufficient in that. Okay, but when the Britishers came, they totally changed the system. Okay, but the Britishers changed the prevalent system and they tried to set up a new system, according to which even the villages were included in that. Okay, whatever changes took place at the center, now even the villages were included in that. So because of this, the sudden changes which were coming to the villages, this brought about instability and insecurity in the minds of the people. The people in the villages, they got frightened with a sudden change like this. And so they were not at all very much happy about the British rule. Now let's talk about the economic causes. According to the new revenue system of British tax, okay, we have learned what was the revenue system of British. What was the revenue system of British? Yes. That is measuring the land, and depending upon the land, they have to pay the taxes. And that also in cash, not in kind. Correct? So, taxes were forcibly extracted from farmers. Okay, forcibly, anyhow, whether you are cultivating that land or you are not cultivating, you have to pay the taxes. So this was like a force which led to the agriculture collapse. Slowly by slowly, the farmers lost their lands and the agriculture slowly by slowly came to an end. Hardly any people were doing agriculture now. Okay, many people had lost their land where they are going to do agriculture. So there was a collapse of agriculture. Okay. Now, what was the aim of these Britishers actually? The aim of the Britishers was gaining profit by selling British goods in India. Okay, what was the main aim of the Britishers? To gain more and more profit by selling their own goods in India. That was the main aim. So what they did for that? They started imposing heavy taxes on the local industries. When a product is taxed more, okay, suppose a certain thing is there. If it is taxed more, what happens? The thing becomes expensive. Same thing happened here also. The local industries, whatever products were produced over here, they were taxed more. So the product also became more expensive. While if you see the British goods were not paying so much of tax. So their good was very much cheaper. So if you are the consumer, if you are the customer, which good you will take? You will take an expensive one or you will take a cheaper one? Naturally, you will go for the cheaper one. So this way, what happened? Slowly by slowly, the local industries came to an end. Nobody is taking the goods. And what they are going to produce then? So slowly by slowly the local industries were closed down. Handicraft and textile industry of India were also ruined. Okay, we have learned in the previous lesson, handicraft and textile industry, which were worldwide famous. Okay, it was wanted in the whole world, the beautiful handicraft and the textiles of India. Now this was fully ruined. Why? Because slowly by slowly it was taken over by the British goods. So because of which many artisans also became unemployed, they lost their jobs. Okay, no work to do then. So this created a discontent in the minds against British. Slowly by slowly all these things, all these economic causes led to a discontent in the minds of the people against the British. Okay, till here everyone has understood. So what we have learned till now? We have learned about the economic causes and the causes for the struggle of 1857. Let's continue. Now, let's move on to the next one, that is social causes. I think so this cause also I have already explained to you then also. As I have already told you, the interference of the Britishers in the social and cultural life of the people was not at all liked by the people. Okay, you all must be knowing about Lord Dalhousie, who had started the widow remarriage. Then Lord William Bentinck, who had stopped the sati system, practice of sati system. Now for years together, the Indians had been following this culture. Okay, and they think that it was the best one for them. And it was their culture and they were very much attached to that culture. And because of the Britishers, all this culture had come to an end. All this had stopped, which the people did not like at all. They started thinking that these Britishers, foreigners who are coming here, they are interfering too much in our life. We don't want them anymore. So this were the social causes. Okay. Next is the political causes. Let's see what is the political causes. You know, in the year 1757, the Britishers had taken many of the Indian states, took charge of many of the Indian states. Okay, first of all, it was taken away from the East India Company. The Britishers took the full charge in their own hands. And because of which, Lord Dalhousie had come over here. Lord Dalhousie annexed many princely states. When he came over here, he started annexing many princely states on different grounds, on various grounds. Now, which were the grounds? For example, the Nawab of Ayodhya was dethroned. What is the meaning of dethroned? That means he was removed from the throne. Okay, the Nawab of Ayodhya was dethroned on grounds of maladministration. What is the meaning of maladministration? That means his administration was not efficient. Okay, he was not doing his duty properly. It was said like that. Okay, and he was removed from the throne. So in that way, he was removed from the throne. And Nawab of, that is, Ayodhya went into the hands of Dalhousie, Lord Dalhousie. Then apart from that, the princely states of Satara, Nagpur, Jhansi, they were also annexed. On what basis? On the doctrine of lapse. What is the meaning of doctrine of lapse? That means if a king is not having his heir, that is a son, to sit on the throne, then that kingdom will go to the Britishers. So on the basis of this, even the princely states of Satara, Nagpur and Jhansi were taken away. We know about the Satara, what we have learned about, who was that? Chhatrapati Pratap Singh. Then we know about Rani Jhansi also. She also did not have her own son. Okay. Due to Lord Dalhousie's such type of behavior of Lord Dalhousie, the Indians did not trust the British at all. Okay, because of all these reasons, the Indians were not at all ready to believe in the Britishers at all. Okay, so this was the political cause of the uprising of 1857. Yes. Till here everyone has understood. So children, what have we learned in this lecture today? Yes, we have learned about the political causes. How one by one Lord Dalhousie had taken over most part of India. Okay, by way of dethroning the Nawab of Ayodhya on grounds of maladministration, then on the doctrine of lapse. Okay, these were the reasons given, but actually one by one he was taking away the states under the British rule. Then we have learned about the social causes also. Okay, what were the social causes? The people were very much angry because of the too much interference of the Britishers in their life. That was the social cause. Then we have also learned about the economic causes. What were the economic causes? How the agriculture came to an end. Country like India, which was an agriculture country. Okay, agricultural country like India, when agriculture is only not there, what is the economy of that country then? Okay, above that, some small local industries were there that also lost. They also were closed down just because of the heavy taxes imposed on them. Then the handicraft and the textile industry was also ruined. Okay, because of which artisans lost their jobs. All these were the economic causes which led to the uprising of 1857. Then the causes, various other causes were there, like the inclusion of the villages in the new system, okay, which was not at all accepted by the people. Okay, the people were not at all happy. They were very much they had created a feeling of instability and insecurity, okay, in the minds. All this, as well as the discontent among the soldiers also, there was a discontent among the soldiers. So all these were the various reasons for the uprising of 1857. Okay. So children, that's all for today. We'll remaining part of the lesson we'll do in the next lecture. Till then, thank you.